We've done a few videos on passwords, cracking passwords, choosing good passwords. And I've had a few requests both by email and, you know, Twitter and on, in the comments about choosing a password mechanism called Diceware. So I thought we'd look at this and think, what's the pros and cons of this quite interesting system for choosing passwords? So here's my nice unbiased casino dice that I got just for this occasion. I was quite excited. Apparently this dice is not biased towards rolling a 6, which actually would just mean my performance in games goes down. When we spoke about passwords last time, my hypothetical password mechanism was something like 4 random words with a bit of symbols added in, maybe randomly in the middle of a word. Now, I chose that because I felt it was a nice compromise between having to type something in that's really, really long, and having something that's not too hard to remember, but also quite hard to break. Now, Diceware is in some sense quite similar to this scheme, but it's perhaps more mathematically defined exactly how hard it is to break, which is why people like it. Because I think the question comes down to, in my scheme, if I pick 4 random words, how random are those words truly? If an attacker wanted to brute force my password, then, and they know, for example, that I'm using 4 words appended together, then what they're going to want to do is try and work out the list of all the words I might have used. Now, I try and throw them off a bit by using slightly odd words, but I'm a bit weird. But for the majority of people, let's imagine that everyone in the country or everyone in the world is using this password scheme. Lots of people are going to pick really easy words. You know, back to the correct false battery staple thing. XKCD alluded to this, and we'll talk about that in a minute. It didn't necessarily answer every question, but it did get a good message across. The entropy, or the number of possible words that you've chosen, is going to differ from person to person, right? If one of my words I pick is database, is that because I've picked that right out at random, or is it because it says databases on this book up here and I accidentally saw it in the corner of my eye? Don't pan to the bit with no books on it.
Yeah, I'm just looking at your collection of cubes.
All solved, that's how I roll. So what Diceware does, the website was established in 1995 by a guy called Arnold Reinhold from the United States. What it is a way of using dice to ensure that the words you're picking are actually random rather than just what you think is random. And that way we have a very nicely defined, should we say, mathematical difficulty for brute forcing that password. So this is the Diceware list, but I guess it's a kind of compromise between the number of dice you just have to roll incessantly to come up with passwords and being fairly quick. But there are 7,776 words on this, which is all the different combinations of 5 dice rolls. Right, now, so that's why I've got my nice unbiased dice. We don't want to be accidentally biasing me towards the end of this document, for example. So as an example, we roll the dice, it's a 5. Each of these has 5 numbers from 1 to 6 in front of the word, which tells you which word you're going to pick. So these are the 4s, I'm onto the 5s, there's the start of the 5s there. I'm going to roll the dice again, it's a 6. So I'm now onto the 5 6s, which is here. And then again, 5 6 4, 5 1. 5 6 4 5 1 is the word tapir, as in the animal with a snout. So, that's the first word of my password, so let me write that down. This could take a little while. This is where you need to use all of your video editing skills. Tapir. Right, let's do this again. Okay. 1 3 2 1 3. If you've done this a lot of times, maybe you'd be faster. 1 3 2 1 3. There we are, back up. Nice. 5 1 3 3. Ask, what is it? 1 5 1 3 3 1.
How many times have you got to do this?
Good question. Rand, interesting. R-A-N-D.
Oh, South African currency.
Yeah, and also short for random, which is what we're doing now. 5 2 4 6 2 RW, interesting.
Read write.
Yeah, so not all of these are full words. That's one of the things that's quite interesting about this. 3 6, I haven't been into the threes yet, it's very exciting. 3 6 4 2 2. 3 6 4 2 2.
Are these dice guaranteed to be fair?
They're guaranteed to be unbiased, I think. But then I got them cheaply off the internet, so I don't actually know. Okay, so let's stop there. I've got 5 words, right? Now, is this password any good? Well, the first thing to note is that what you don't want to do when you're picking a password is record it on video and show it on the internet. So I probably won't put this as my actual password. But there will be a few people that try, nonetheless. We roll the dice 5 times per word, we find the word, and then we put spaces in between it, and that's our passphrase, right? So that is literally our password then for whatever purpose we want. Why is this better than what I was doing? Well, it's different, mostly. There's a few questions we've got, right? The first is this a reasonable password in terms of strength? Also, how practical is it to type in? Right, it took a little while to generate, but if you're doing it a couple of times for the front end of a password manager, maybe that's not such a big deal. One thing that's worth noting is that this isn't all the words in the English language. This is a carefully chosen 7,700 words, but are nice and short. So most of the words are fewer than 5 characters. There's a few really short ones. The idea being that even if you've got a 5-word or a 6-word passphrase, it's never going to get that long. You should get quite quick at typing it in. But the real benefit of this system is that these are actually random, as opposed to what I perceive to be random because I thought of a word in my head, right, which might have been a word that I happened to see on the side of a bus this morning.
In a previous video. So we talked about brute forcing and about not knowing what any of the characters were and how we make it easier for the attacker by using a dictionary of known words.
Yeah.
So this is literally providing the dictionary, right?
Yeah, that's the drawback in some sense and the strength. So we know exactly what words could appear in my passphrase, but even so, we still can't break it because I've used too many of them. So in some password schemes, like ones where I pick words at random from a dictionary in my own brain, I'm working under the assumption that that's secure because no one else knows how it works. Right? No one can reverse engineer that process. That might be true, it might not be true. Right? It depends how well you know me. The process is extremely open. Everyone knows what the password list was. Everyone knows what my password is going to be like, but they still can't break it because it's 2^64 operations, which is too much. What we don't want is security through obscurity. Right? If I only use a 500-word dictionary, right, that's fine as long as I keep that dictionary secret. But that doesn't seem like a very good idea because then that dictionary might accidentally come out and then it would be incredibly easy to break my password. So what is the strength of this password? Well, each of these words has come from 7,776, right? So we can assume that the attacker knows that I'm using this password scheme. So they know my password is 5 words separated by spaces, which adds nothing because they know what the spaces are. Out of a possible 7,776. So the strength of this password is actually 7776^5. So another way of looking at it is in how many bits of entropy does this password have? A lot of the time that's how we view passwords. Each of these words is 12.9 bits. So 12.9 times by 5 words is 64.5 bits, which is pretty good, actually. That means that on average, an attacker is going to have to do about 2^63, 2^64 operations to guess your password in brute force. That's quite a lot of operations, particularly given they're going to have to perform some hash to do this. The nice thing about this password scheme is we know exactly how secure it is, right? As opposed to we're guessing that the words aren't just words that I know and someone can social engineer those words. And also, if we want it to be more secure, we can just add another word or another word. As computational power goes up, we just add more words. And we can probably remember a few words, or if they get really long, write them down and put it in our wallet. Don't lose it.
I'm guessing as well you could potentially vary the whole spaces thing, right?
Yeah, so the spaces thing is not hugely important. The reason it's there is because sometimes you might accidentally join 2 words together and there might actually be a different word on here, in which case your search has gone down to 4 words, right? So if you're being careful that these are all actually different words and they don't concatenate to make another word, you don't need the spaces. Or you could use a different character. You could also do what I did and use fewer words and put a random character in, right? Now, on the website, he has plenty of ways of rolling dice and also choosing random characters. Because again, when I pick a symbol, it's often, you know, a star or an ampersand or an underscore. Those aren't all the characters that exist. So it's a really interesting twist on picking passwords. This came about, you know, a few years ago now, where maybe a four-word password was reasonable. Now, in some sense, you can't imagine that 7 or 8 or 9-word passwords are that feasible for the majority of users. There has to be some usability considerations. But on the other hand, 5 is not too bad. Or, as I say, 4, but then make an unexpected alteration, like an adding of a random symbol, at a random position, not between the words. And that will significantly increase the amount of time it would take to break. You can get too carried away, right, with password security. I have, and so half the time I can't log in because I get my password wrong. And so I've but the thing also you have to remember is that this is way beyond a normal brute force attack by someone who just happens to have found your password hash on Pastebin. Right? This is, when we're talking about 5 or 6 word passwords, we're talking about nation state level. Right? And you've got to really wonder whether they really care about your individual password. You might still want to secure it against them anyway. Right? That's for you to decide. But they may just visit you instead. We'll put a link to the website in the description as well, so you can have a look through. He's considered almost every possible angle for this. So when do you add symbols? How many words is enough for the level of security you want? It's a really good, interesting look into password security. So I recommend you have a look.